So we've been doing it for about 18 years now, and it's a great pipeline program in which we have medical students, undergraduate, college students, and high school students. And basically, the students mentor each other, and they do two health fairs, which we're doing right now, and we also do some community-based research, we do community health talks, and we do a lot of mentoring. So the idea is that the medical students can mentor the undergraduates, and the undergraduates can then mentor the high school students. And then we also bring in our family medicine residents that hopefully try to encourage the medical students to aspire for careers in working with poverty and inner-city medicine. And we hope that they choose primary care and family medicine or intermediate.
Yeah, they're like all the same.
So that's what the program is about. Each year we have maybe about a dozen medical students, maybe about 20 undergraduates, and about 30 to 40, sometimes 50 high school students. Just a busy, busy program. About 100 volunteers that participate in each health fairs, and through the years, we've come to about an average of close to 400 people that are served by the health fairs. So usually, one health fair may be about 100 to 150 people, and then the second health fair, usually about 300 people that will actually participate in the health fair. And we feel that the health fair's goal is really to bridge the people to the services that are available to them. It's not the goal of the health fair to provide health care, it's to make them think about their health. So we do blood sugar checks, we do blood pressure checks, we do anemia screening, and we do that to try to stimulate thought about these diseases so that people can think about their blood pressure, think about their blood sugar, think about their weight, think about doing exercise, try to stimulate them to take a healthy step, and then we give them information about what services are available to them. So our doctors go over the results with them, but then we also give them referral centers, or we give them a phone number where they can call, where they can then get more continuous kind of care, which is the ultimate goal, is for them to get a long-term type of health care.
Noticed that we've been doing a lot of work in community. How has community and the health of the community inspired you to become a doctor?
Well, I guess growing up, my family didn't have access to healthcare, and you know, to me, that was really important to make sure that I went out there and connected with people like my family, people from my community, that you know, to bring affordable healthcare to them. So my passion is I want to help others have care.
I just wanted to, you know, first get your name, and then could you describe, you know, why this health fair was, you know, useful and important for you? If there's one thing you can take away from our program, what is one thing you could use to, you know, make an impact from your community? Or what is one thing you have learned?
Well, one thing that I have learned is, for example, how today during the health fair, I was doing the registration booth, and I came across a lot of families. And for example, one of them, it was a family of five, and father is the only one who works, and he makes about $350 every 2 weeks, and I just saw in a year that's that's a lot. That's a little bit of money. And how is it possible that he could sustain the entire family of five just like that? So that's one thing that I can take from this program, is how grateful I am, and how when we first started, we didn't think that I didn't think that this is what my community was based off of, because I've been lucky enough where I don't have to deal with that. And I feel that this has inspired me to want to be a primary doctor, because when I first started, I was like, oh, I want to be a surgeon. I want to be a neurosurgeon. I want to make a lot of money. But now that I think about it, I feel I would make more of an impact with the people in my community.
I got involved in the Harbor-UCLA program as a premedical student. The opportunity to volunteer and take care of patients here in the community, where a lot of the patients speak Spanish and have no access to healthcare, was a really neat opportunity coming from these types of communities, because I was able to see the reflection of the patients in my own experiences with my family, and how being them in access care, and also serving as an interpreter. And then as I became a medical student, got involved in leadership, this was a really neat vehicle to get other students involved, to see the power they have in taking care of other patients, and staying on the path so that they can also become doctors and go back to their community and serve people who traditionally have been left out. And so coming to this health fair today, here in Gardena, California, it is really inspiring to see so many young pre-health students and medical students and other healthcare professionals working together to really provide a service that's needed and that is able to change the lives of people, because they have someone who really cares about them.